No mai hoki mai. Welcome back to Q&A. Last year's election brought a huge group of new MPs into Parliament, many of them also quite new to politics. Well, this morning in our First Term Faces series, Whena Owen catches up with two Auckland-based MPs with very different stories.
Kia ora, I'm Naisi Chen and I'm a Labour List MP based in Botany. So this morning we're going to have an event called Art Out East, and that's where we can meet lots of young and emerging artists here living in here in East Auckland.
Why are you walking so slow because of your heels?
Oh, these are shoes are my little guilty pleasure. Like, it's the only thing that I actually collect in the world.
You know, Paula Bennett was like that.
I'm not going to be called the second Paula Bennett.
So we'll just watch you do your mahi and mingle. How old were you when you came up from Beijing?
Five. Yeah, so don't remember much. So I did all my schooling kind of here in New Zealand.
Okay.
I have been back to China since, but it's, yeah, but New Zealand's very much my home.
Hi everyone, my name's Naisi Chen and I'm a Member of Parliament for Aotearoa New Zealand.
The first comment that came out on that live video was that, oh my gosh, you speak with a Kiwi accent. Like, I think people just automatically assume that if I was Chinese, I was in politics, that I would speak with a Chinese accent.
You're the only Chinese MP at the moment.
Absolutely, yeah. And obviously I think one is to not just pigeonhole me, I guess. That's a really, like, people don't just think I'm in Parliament to advocate just for that community or just for issues to do with China. That's never who I am. You know, I think I'm really, you know, strong advocate for the arts sector, for the youth in New Zealand.
What was it like when your loyalty was being questioned a few years ago?
Yeah, that was really hurtful to start with, because I just feel like I've call New Zealand my, you know, home for all my life, that all the life that I've known, and I've always kind of been really proud that I'm a Kiwi. I would call it racism, because I think they just saw a Chinese person in politics, they thought you must be working in some other capacity, you know, and that I think is just lazy.
Do you know why they came to that conclusion though? Because of course that you were the head of the New Zealand Chinese Students Association, which they say has links to the United Front under the CCP.
Yeah.
So does it?
No, absolutely not.
So do you feel free to, like, make a comment or a statement about Tiananmen Square?
Yeah, I stand on my values, and those I think are extremely well aligned with the Labour Party values and what our party does. And obviously we have.
So you would condemn that action?
Whatever the Labour, look, we've got a foreign diplomatic policy, and Anaya has made her statements on that, and I stand by those. I feel extremely lucky to be in this term of Parliament together, but I am the baby of caucus at the moment, and I think it's so lucky that I am, because I think everyone just looks after me so well. I've got people, colleagues who are my mother's age in there, and they just really dote on me and really look after me.
Okay, 11:30, what have you got to do next?
Yes, I've just got about 10 more minutes here, and then I have to go meet up with actually one of our local board members to talk a little bit about what we can do for the environment here in East Auckland.
How do I say xie xie?
Yeah, xie xie.
Xie xie.
And then zai jian is goodbye.
Zai jian.
Zai jian.
Zai jian.
Zai jian. Zai jian. Thanks,
Hi, I'm Karen Chhour. I'm a List MP for the ACT Party. I'm based in Upper Harbour on the North Shore in Auckland.
So why did you choose ACT?
I just liked what they stood for. I liked the principle of personal responsibility. I kind of have it in my mind that why can't we have a prosperous society with a social conscience, and I don't think you should have to choose. This is the centre of the community for me. Four of my kids have come through this school.
So you're a mum of four children and you're married to a Kiwi who came out here as a Cambodian refugee. Yep. I got that right?
Yes. Yeah, he came when he was a baby with his parents who came here as refugees.
You grew up in many households, didn't you?
I started off with the family, like they were trying to find family that would take me in. That didn't really turn out too well. And when you know a family member is taking you, but not really because they want to, but they feel like they have to, it's kind of hard to feel like you belong. Ethnicity and culture should not be how we decide what's in the best interest of our children. Ōranga tamariki should be colourblind and open to whatever will ensure a child's well-being and safety. I stayed with a lady who took me in, who had a lot of foster children go through her house, and she was a stable place for me for a while, and she taught me life skills. She taught me that I did have a place in this world. So the first home we bought is just down the road from this school. My children could walk to this school.
And that was a significant moment for you?
Yes, because it was the first time I knew I'd just laid some roots. I knew that I was never going to have to move, and I was going to be able to have some stability for my family, which I never had growing up.
Do you mind if I ask you about what happened to you in Copperfields, Parliament's cafe?
Yeah.
Is that...
No worries. So I tapped Brooke on the shoulder and I said to her, oh, I really can't breathe right now. And she kind of went, what? And I can't breathe. So I got sat down and they went and got some help. And
who did they get?
Shane Retty. So,
oh my goodness, if you're going to have a medical
yes.
emergency, you want to have it around Shane
yes.
Retty, I imagine.
Yes, and he was very calming, and he kept me sane until the ambulance could come.
So all these people warning you that Parliament's such a horrible place, you've seen the other side of it too.
I think putting politics aside, everybody that goes in there has their reasons, and they've gone in there to make a change, and they all want New Zealand to be a better place. Well, we just disagree about how to go about it.